What's your name?
Guitar Ron.
Guitar Ron.
Yeah.
You're good.
Thank you, man.
Getting funky.
Exhibition in the New York Observer and decided that I would definitely have to come down and check this out. I think Alice Neel is one of the most interesting and maybe insightful figurative painters in New York, at least in the last 50 years. She died in 1984. This piece is titled Jeffrey Hendricks and Brian. And I seem to remember, I think some guy, Jeffrey Hendricks, might have been involved with Fluxus. This is from 1978. It's 46 by 36. Oh, this blue line she's using is great. Now, I think the other wonderful part of the story is that Alice Neel really had a hard life. I think that she was pretty much a single mother. I think she had one or two children that survived. This is Stephen Shepherd, 34 by 26. And she lived uptown in Harlem, or near Harlem. It's titled Roses. But she made a lot of sacrifices to keep up her practice, and was always considered kind of a eccentric and a hobbyist until probably late in her career, probably about the time that she was doing these paintings, maybe in the mid-late 60s, and then she became one of the champions of proto-feminism, I guess you'd call it. This is titled Nancy. 45 by 59. And she was incredible capturing her character of her sitters. Well, they're calling this Lake Portraits and Still Lives, but I think maybe there's a lot more still life, or a lot more portraits than there are still lives. He's also a pretty good colorist. This is titled Light. Oh, that's great, the way that shadow comes off the stand. Let's take a quick sweep around the main gallery section. Well, one of the good things about this show is that it really is a museum quality exhibition, and this is one of those shows that Jerry Saltz is always talking about. The modern Museum of Modern Art is falling down on the job because they're not producing shows like this. They're leaving it to the commercial galleries, but in this case, we're pretty lucky. I like this. This is a pretty simple, straight-ahead double portrait of Kevin and Andy. And she's got a great use of color for these skin tones, but a lot of these colors are not what I would call flesh tones. She also uses a lot of greens and grays. But that green shirt and that orange arm is great. Something else that's interesting, I was looking at the side of this canvas. Look at that, 1788. And one of the odd paradoxes about the work is that you can see that she uses distortion, that this guy's head is a little larger maybe than it should be, but somehow that kind of exaggeration only allows you to get a more realistic, maybe accurate view of the character of the sitters. I kind of like the way she left this hand and knee unfinished. Is Lester Cole. I also think there's kind of a relationship between this kind of obsessive concentration on the figure and breaking away from abstract expressionism and what painters like Lucian Freud were doing about 25 or 30 years later. This is titled Hartley. ft/47" from 1978. There is an abstract quality about that, especially with that punchy cobalt blue of those pants. This is titled Richard, and they say in the press release that she picked her portrait subjects from her family, local Bohemia, plumbers, all kinds of places. This guy looks like a lawyer, maybe. This is Hugh Hurd. Neel is also great at capturing the moment, kind of the fleeting emotional states of these sitters. Still life. 1964. Oh, that's a scene that every New Yorker knows, looking out the fire escape. This is Sherry Spieth. Alice is kind of capturing the whole hippie mood here, not just with the color and the gesture, but also with, you know, the concentration on the clothes. All these have a very spontaneous freshness to them. Looking at these, and I commented that she uses a lot of different colors for her skin tones, but the amount of grays and greens makes me think of the great Italian painter Montaigne, or maybe early Max Beckmann. Oh, this is a beautiful piece. Little Abe's grandchildren. 35.5 by 28.5. Oh, it's got a lot of lovely silvery grays and powdery blues. David Zwirner, 525 West 19th Street in Chelsea. Thank you, Kate.
Great summer.
Wow, thank you.
For your donations if you felt the music.